to what you are in this clothes and the look.
Yes.
You were in this fit lady.
Not much of a fit lady.
And then you visited a doctor for some reason, and they said something to you which actually changed you.
Yes.
Can you narrate those wonderful stories? That is very important for the audience to know.
I think it's very important that everyone who is not aware of this has to get a brief about what exactly health issues could be. And many people, I think, as I'm getting into the fibromyalgia subject, I see there are many people who are fighting fibromyalgia without even knowing the name, the term, fibromyalgia, what exactly fibromyalgia is. They hardly even know.
Okay.
But they are being, it's a chronic disease that they have been fighting, and they are unable to explain this to people around them because they themselves do not know what exactly is going around with them. Right? So that thing has become my priority, apart from being a weight loss expert and getting help, you know, maybe like a fancy thing that's going on, the weight loss. So I do give weight loss, but they have to understand why the health is not supporting them, right?
Okay.
What things are blocking them to be what they want to be? So let be obesity, let be any kind of thing that they are wanting from their life, why aren't they able to get the correct help, right?
No.
So there are factors behind such things. So if you consider me, say about 5 to 6 years back, how I was totally bedridden.
Oh.
Yes. When I was writing my exam for my, as a nutritionist, when I was writing my final exam, I wasn't even able to hold my hand.
Oh.
And I was, my sister was continuously giving me a massage on my hand. So like
it's
I
very bad.
It was. It was like a fight for me to,
okay,
you know, just finish that 3 hours of exam was a fight.
And what exam?
Nutrition.
Yes.
Okay. So I felt there was something going on which I have to, you know,
change about you.
Yes. So I had two options any which ways, that be on bed for rest of my life and otherwise be examined to someone. So what I decided was to go to a doctor and come out.
It's a wonderful liner. Either be on the bed for the rest of your life or be an example for someone. So it's quite a quote, you can take it up. All the way coming from Jyoti Jeshnasmi's beautiful words.
So I went to a doctor because since I was already into nutrition and I knew the side effects of paracetamol, painkillers and antidepressant pills.
You were on them drugs for a long time?
No, I wasn't. I was prescribed B12.
Okay.
Yes, I was prescribed B12, but when I checked my report, I was already higher side on B12. So I didn't want to get into a problem. So that's where I figured out that I need to show somebody who could really figure out my problem. So I've been hunting around doctors, getting many scans done, many treatments, and nothing worked completely. So what I did was somebody told me this fibromyalgia that you have.
Okay.
So once the term was there,
okay,
I started surveying.
Reading about
said,
it.
Yes,
yeah.
A lot of Google help that I have taken. So I was trying to figure out, and at the midway I used to get completely gray because there were everything negative possibly written about fibromyalgia. It is a chronic disease, degenerative disease, you lose all muscles and you age fast, you have widespread body pain and irritable bowel syndromes, fatigue mind, fatigue brain, your body is lethargy all the time, and then it comes with mental blocks. And it's like
so you went through all these things?
Yes, of course.
And how tough was it? You know,
it was very tough.
I know it's very easy to give up on your problems in life, and we curse so much about all the issues that we have. The young lady over there on the camera, she says she's got migraine and she doesn't want to continue doing the aerobics.
I think after we finish the
interview, she's an inspired, she's an inspired person, and Nadi will be very happy for that. Becomes very inspired.
Tejaswini, I can cure your migraine, so you know what to be done soon after the
session.
So I went to a doctor with all the problems, whatever I had. And since I told you I was a very stubborn and very strong-headed person as a child itself, and he gave me two choices.
Okay.
When he told me this is what your prescription is all about, 4 painkillers and 2 antidepressants.
Okay.
And I was like, you know how it is, anti-depression. I'm like, excuse me, you know, I'm not going to take anti-depression, I'm not, you know, mentally sick. So he told me, now you have two choices that you can make for yourself. If you how long can I go on with painkiller? Because it's a chronic disease, it's going to go with my diet. Yes, it's going to go with my diet. So I asked him how long, you know, and the doctor was very, I think he was a good man who told me, give me a right path. He told me you can take medication and live happily as long as you survive. And the second thing, if you have questions like this, kya hoga, kaise hoga, ye dawai kab tak chalegi, meri health kharab hogi, mera liver kharab
hoga. You're never able to consume it or do it.
So he told me quit medication. You have end slow your life, you know. So when he told me, when, in spite of having all the body pain and I'm facing a tough time already, a negative thing that coming all the way from the doctor, I banged his table. Bad attitude, but I banged his table and I told him, this is the last time
you're
going to see me, but definitely you will see me dying 100 years with a smiling face without taking medication.
Wow, that's a wonderful love. Yes. And that's why you have this beautiful smile on you with the lovely dimples that you've got.
It's the success that smiles
you. It is
the success. Yeah. So I told him that I'm going to smile all my life. Never want to get back to the painkiller, then you'll never see me one day. So every morning it's a struggle for me to get up, fight myself.
I totally understand.
Yes, but I feel happy. I feel more motivated when I get up than not getting up and being on the bed for the rest of the day.
For the audience, Jyoti is an inspirational story which is already written on the Facebook blog of 100 Women Corners of Hyderabad show. She's not just a survivor who fought her problems, physical problems that she has had, but she's a winner now, and now she's going to come out with a book. Alright, now, and that's where we met, that she actually thought that I could help her out with the book. And I still didn't do it. I can be a nice host for the one of these book launch that you could.
You are the ultimate host that I would be.
Thank you. Thank you. Wow, I gotta get this up. Ravi, there's another compliment from another lady coming by the way. So can you just talk about the book? What would the book be all about fibromyalgia or about generally combating pain? I think it's more about yoga,
yes,
wellness, happiness, keeping yourself good.
Yes.
Yeah.
Basically, before I start with the book, I would want everyone to know what exactly fibromyalgia is. Apart from the thing you can Google about what fibromyalgia is, there's something called lactic acid that is continuously being produced in your system. Right?
Does it go like this? Keeps going around? Yeah.
So